Good day, everyone. My name is Robin Dolezal, and this is Alex Pars. We are with Ironwood Financial. Today, we want to talk about what we call Mini-Roth conversions. So let's talk about why we do this. With the new tax codes, right, we've got this first layer of 12%, right? If we're married, we've got up to $77,000-ish of taxable income can now be taxed at 12%. And then we've also got our standard deduction. So a couple making roughly $100,000 is in the 12% bracket.
That's insane. Right. Yeah, that's insane. That is ridiculous. And this only goes on, theoretically, for a few years. Again, getting into that 12% bracket is almost 100 grand for a married couple of gross income. So many of our clients, they don't spend that much.
Right. Okay?
And they've got big IRAs that they're hesitant to take money out of. And particularly for those people who are in their 60s, this is something you really need to think about. Because once you hit 70, what happens?
You get your RMDs.
Required minimum distributions. Suddenly your income goes up because you have to take more money out of your 401k or your IRA just so Uncle Sam can get their tax money. Here's a way to avoid some of that pain. Okay, what you do is, let's say you're spending $65,000 a year, which is very common for our clients, mm-hmm. and you've got a portfolio of maybe 800 grand in your 401k. Okay, if you let that money grow, by the time you hit 70, if you're 65, that might be $1.2 million, it might be $1.5 million, and suddenly you've got an RMD of $60,000-$80,000 a year that's all taxable.
Right.
Okay. So what you can do, and this is particularly attractive under the new tax code, is fill that 12% bracket.
Right.
So what you do is you do a Roth conversion for the difference between your gross income and roughly that $100,000 if you're married, different numbers if you're single, and boom, that becomes taxable income this year. Okay. Remember in our previous video, we didn't want you doing a $200,000, $300,000 Roth conversion because that puts you in a top bracket. Now we're talking about little ones. Maybe it's $20,000, maybe it's $50,000, maybe it's $5,000. Okay. And you convert that and you pay 12% this year on that money. Remember in, what is it supposed to be, 5-7 years, that 12% bracket goes away. We're back to the 15 unless Congress changes it. Okay.
Right.
So right there, we're saving a few percentage from the future when you have to do RMDs. And as we talked about earlier, you might not be in the 15% bracket if your RMDs are really high. So by taking $10,000, $20,000, $50,000 a year, use the example of $50,000 over 5 years, that's $250,000 plus growth that you've pulled out of your 401k and put it into a pocket that you never have to pay taxes on again.
That's right. It's great to have those two pockets, isn't it? I mean, anytime someone says, you know what, I found this great investment opportunity, or I want to take this great vacation, or I want to help Junior buy a house, now we've got this great pocket that we can take some extra money and that actually boosts our income out.
Yeah, keep in mind, of course, you do have to let money that you do convert into a Roth sit for 5 years before you take it. Otherwise, it's subject to penalties and taxes. But again, if we're trying to lower our RMD and put money aside in cheap money or cheap taxes, this is a good way to do it.
Yeah. Don't forget, your Roth IRAs do not have that same required minimum distribution either.
Yeah. So this money could sit there until you're 100 years old, growing, tax deferred and withdrawable, and you can pass it to your heirs income tax free. This is a great way to stay away from Uncle Sam for the rest of your life, with that money at least.
That's right. If you have any questions on our mini Roth conversion video, send us an email. Thanks for watching our videos. We've got tons of other great videos. You can watch them on Facebook. We've got our webpage, ironwoodfinancial.com. Until next time, thanks for watching.